Howdy folks, I'm Glenn, and this is Slim, and you found the Cactus Atlas. Today, we begin our journey right off of Highway 163, the Navajo Code Talker Highway near Bluff, Utah. Well, Slim, are you ready for this adventure, buddy? Today I'm going to be taking you about 5 miles down to the San Juan River on a 4x4 trail, not suitable, I heard, for passenger cars. Sounds like your specialty, buddy, doesn't it?
Sure does, Glenn, sure does.
And this cattle guard marks the barrier as we enter Comb Ridge. Lots of cool history and scenic beauty down there, I hear anyway. All right, let's head down in the Comb Ridge, see how we do today. I was talking to a fellow traveler. He said there's a problem down here trying to get across a wash, and I see the side-by-side turning around, so this could be the quickest episode ever. Actually, never mind, he's heading down a different road. Is that what the guy was talking about? All right, that ain't gonna happen. No way. Gonna have to try to find our way around. It's a deep wash. Really deep. Let's get out on foot and scout this out and see. Great start. All right, so this is what the guy's talking about. And I don't know. It's pretty steep. I see on my map, I think there's a route over that way, and I hear a side-by-side over there, but I don't know if he's trying to get across that too. Because this is really like right there. It's like very sharp, and I don't know how deep this is. Oh man, yeah, I don't know if I want to attempt that today without someone to help spot or guide me through that. My best option, I think, is to try to circle around this and go around where I think I may have seen a different way. This here, I would probably attempt no problem. It's this right there that I'm unsure of. And then this is really muddy, silty stuff, so I don't know if I'd get stuck in there or what. Ay, ay, ay. You could see there used to be a bridge or a paved road that went over this at one point, and the wash took it out, I guess. It's beautiful though. It's beautiful. All right, I'm listening for the side-by-side. If the side-by-side got through, I might be okay, but I don't know if he's coming back this way. He may have abandoned or aborted the mission. Might be the quickest Cactus Atlas video ever, but I do think on my offline maps, I might see a way it wraps around. So, woohoo, adventure. Yeah, I think he got past. I can hear him out that way, so I have hope. It's this road here that we're gonna try, and uh-oh, maybe he is coming back this way. We're gonna go find out for ourselves. Actually, I do see, I think it's the guy that drove by me. Someone's out there on that side and made it, but they're kind of going back and forth. Maybe they lost their way. Huh, all right, let's not dilly-dally. Let's try this. Alrighty, let's back her up. Back him up, it's a Slim. I'm sorry, Slim, I didn't mean to call you a her. All right. Cross your fingers, folks, but we gotta get this puppy into four-wheel drive, too. Already, I see the potential for sand, and I've read a little bit about this area. I'll explain in a minute what we're doing. There's quite a bit to this. All right, we got all 4 feet ready to roll. I think I saw the guy turn down this way. And we will see what we can do here. Probably some dispersed camping sites back here. Not afraid to get Slim wet, as long as I can get through it pretty quickly, and we're okay. A little bumpy. Nothing we haven't done before. And there's a sign that shows a wagon, old Conestoga looking wagon, signifying some of the Mormon pioneers that once tried to plow through this area, part of the story today, but not the main attraction or main draw. This is kind of winding through here. It's an adventure. But I think I'm on, looking at my offline maps, I'm on one of the routes. I hear there's many different ways to attack this. So I guess for you people, you can see this. Oh boy, is this the crossing the guy was talking about? All right, let's get out and survey this guy and see what we can do. So how did we do this? All right, this is a little bit less steep, but the question is, can I get back? Because this side looks like the steep side now. All right, this isn't as bad, but it's also not great. Mainly because I just can't see what's underneath here. And I don't know how deep this is, really. Reckon it's not too deep, but this is really steep coming off that. All right, sometimes I kind of do Slim's voice for him. But today, somebody coming so I can watch. That'll help. I might have to move my truck though. This is an obstacle I am very unsure of. It's mainly because I'm in the middle of nowhere. First of all, so if I got stuck and had to get towed out of here or something, that would be bad news. And yeah, this isn't gonna happen. I'm not gonna risk it. Alrighty, we are now back on the road on our Utah road trip. And just wanted to catch up with you because yesterday was a day of filming standalone videos that you either will have seen or will see. Don't know the order things are gonna come out. But had a couple change of plans, which isn't abnormal on the channel. So I figure I'd kind of just catch you up on some of the operations and some of the challenges we have making videos. So yesterday's diversion was, my plan was to go to Monument Valley in the morning, which I did, check, got a video coming for that. Then I wanted to go film a place called Valley of the Gods, which is in the same area, similar to Monument Valley. And I was all psyched up and wanted to camp there. They have dispersed camping all over the place back there. Had been researching it, was really excited. That was maybe one of the pinnacles of the trip. I get out there and I camp in a tent. If you're new here, you didn't know that. I don't have like a overlanding setup or anything, but I'm considering it now. What I didn't really know about that area in Utah is the ground is basically just hard sandstone rock, like sheetrock, covered with like a little bit of dirt. So I could not stake my tent in anywhere. I tried multiple sites. I was like a prospector looking for gold and sampling different areas. Nothing at all. It was like a little bit of red dirt over hard rock. It's just the geology of that area. And to boot, it was getting really gusty and windy, so that was not a good combo. So I decided to just finish the video, which was kind of awkward because the whole intent was to do this overnight thing. So part of the video is searching for a campsite. And campsites I found, but was not able to take advantage of. So that was yesterday. So I decided to go back to Monument Valley to then just stay in a hotel for the night. But now I need to figure out what I'm doing with today, because I also made some other changes of plans where I'm staying tonight and why I did what I did. And now I'm locked into that. So that's the nature of doing this channel, you know? I might give Amy flashbacks to last summer when I went up to Moab and I went to Arches and Canyonlands and went during the height of monsoon season and had some unexpected, unplanned weather. It's another thing you can't really control. And a lot of plans thwarted, changed, had to recalibrate. And I was on the phone with Amy at times when I could get in touch with her and find cell phone coverage. We would talk on the phone and I'd say, okay, well, this isn't gonna happen, so what do I do now? Let's rearrange things. And it always works out. It's not a big deal. You know, on YouTube, one of the things that I like about that the most in this format are there are a lot of like-minded people that do the same thing. And out of those like-minded people, I think some are full-time and do it all the time. Others are like me that work in stiffs, that got a full-time job. And I'm curious for that demographic, that crowd, Like, how do you do your stuff? Like, do you just try to cram it in with trips? How do you get it done? And if you do it like I do it, like, do you have any good stories to tell in the comments? Because I can relate, you know, and it's kind of a fun, I don't know, it's nice to talk to people that have the same problems as me, I guess. All right, so I think here's how I work. I was driving down what were we on there? 191, heading towards Blanding, trying to figure out what to do next. And I think I figured it out. I saw one of those brown signs indicating, you know, national monument, some historical thing, and it's Hovenweep National Monument, one that we've wanted to film, and it's only 28 miles away from here. So there you go. That's what we're doing today for our standalone episode. I don't give up. No. Gonna get this done. And I got a National Parks pass. How do you like me now? All right, so we are back on the road now after filming at Hovenweep National Monument, standalone episode that we will release later. I think I'm about to cross the Utah-Colorado state line right here. This cattle guard, I think, marks it, at least on my Google map. That shows me crossing into Colorado right here.
Welcome to Colorado.
You hear that? Welcome to Colorado. I got distracted there for a moment because I saw a sign that one of the rangers pointed out to me, indicating there are a lot of outlier ruins in this area, outside of the main part of Hovenweep. And you can go, they're open to the public, but they're a little bit harder to get to. So I don't have time today, but noticing that Hovenweep had a campground, and I fell in love with it, honestly. I'm really excited to show that video. It was such a unique place. With a beautiful backdrop, you could see Colorado mountains in the background, all snow-capped. And, best of all, I had our first rattlesnake encounter on the Cactus Atlas. Rattle and everything. So, maybe if Amy releases this video before Hovenweep, you've had your warning now, if you're afraid of that stuff. But, that's all I'm gonna say for now. But, it was awesome. I feel exhilarated still. So the game plan is we're just gonna drive up through a little bit of Colorado, catch some views, get up to the Moab area, catch some more views, and then I've got lodgings arranged for tonight because of a change in plan that I had to do. So, there's so many exciting things to come on the trip. I'm just ready for something like real food at this point. I'm hungry. I thought this was pretty interesting. I am at the Utah state line once again for the second time, coming into Utah from a different state this time. We're leaving Colorado and entering Utah. There's some silliness on that sign, a lot of stickers up there. I'll just let you admire that for a second before we head back out here on the highway. Came up over a bend here and we have another really large mountain in the background. Wonder if that's the La Salle Mountains. That would make sense to me. Because I also see like a lot of red rock now and signs indicative of the Moab area. And we're only like 45 minutes away, 46 miles. So, you know, haven't been filming much on the drive. This has been very indicative of the train. It's starting to get a little bit more mountainous and red. But up until this point, mainly just been juniper forests and flat plains and farmland. The next opportunity I see to pull over, I'm gonna clean that dang windshield because we're in Moab and we don't need bug splatters on the windshield. It's one of my pet peeves. I actually think I see a pull-off. Show you some more behind the scenes Cactus Atlas here. I'm gonna pull over on this busy highway and get my Windex bottle and paper towels out for your entertainment. Ah, and that windshield should be clean for like 2 minutes. Because I think this is the highway where I keep getting the bug splatters. We're not, you know, I don't plan on going to Arches National Park this round. We've been there, done that before, but I figure this is pretty, we're here in this area, so we have to at least see one arch. That would not be proper. Plus, we've been in this dang car for hours sitting down. I gotta get up and, like, stand and do more than washing windshields here. Keep an eye out here. I forget the name of this arch. Didn't even stop to do research, just going by memory, like, oh, there's an arch out here somewhere. And I want to see it, and I see a brown sign, which usually is an indicator that there's something cool to see. And it's called Wilson Arch, 1/2 mile. So that's where we want to go, is to check out Wilson Arch. And there it is, Wilson Arch, right off of 191. Like literally off the highway. There's a guy rappelling right down the center of this thing. It's a beautiful arch. Same size and scope and look as many of the ones you'd see in Arches National Park or other places in the Southwest. They're in abundance out here. Arches never get old, you know? It's cool seeing the guy rappelling down that. It's not something you see every day. I bet if you stripped away all of the dirt out of Valley of Gods underneath where I was trying to stake my tent, this is probably what it honestly was like underneath. Oh, it's nice just to stand out here and get fresh air and catch a breeze. It's a really pretty sight, huh? So this is the room that I chose at the Wingate by Wyndham, right in South Moab, and really modern, and it is clean, just like they said. This is not a hotel review. What we're really here to discuss is the problem that I need to solve and why I've been changing my plans. The problem centers around all of this crap, the magic behind the Cactus Atlas that I need to do. Namely, I need a DC to 12 volt charger that I left at home to charge this guy up, and right now I have 94% power. I could charge it here if I have a regular outlet like this, but when I'm camping, I will not. And I need to keep this thing charged, and I can only do so when I'm driving in my car. And hence why that's so important, because I'm gonna be camping for days at a time, and this is my lifeline, or else none of this stuff would work. So, including the thing I'm filming with. Kind of disappointed in myself because it's something I always think about. It's one of the most critical things on a camping trip. I just haven't been camping in so long that I guess I just have gotten rusty with it. So my best bet is there's a local hardware store, True Value Hardware, down the street, and they don't really even have Home Depot or anything like that here in Moab. So this is the biggest town, my best shot at getting it. Probably next to Grand Junction, Colorado, which does have an REI, they might carry it. So I really need to go. If I can find that, I will have peace of mind and I'll be back on track. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to start like rationing power on the trip. All right, we are checked out, packed up, equipment check, got the drones, got the two cameras that I use, the power source, my big bag of camera equipment and my clothes and everything. I always feel like I'm forgetting something, but I don't think I am. I'm usually have a good track record, but every once in a while, you never know. You guys ever get paranoid like that when you go traveling that you keep thinking you forgot something at the hotel? If so, join the club. And I've already forgotten two things for this trip. One of them I was able to replace, by the way, that equipment I needed to charge my charger. So check, I think I have a solution that works. That was kind of a fiasco. I'll tell you about that in a minute. But first,
head southeast on US 191 South.
We gotta make a left turn onto this very busy highway. All right, I got my coffee from the hotel, and I haven't tasted it yet. I keep wrapping my lips around it to taste it, but I've been talking too much here. So let's try this hotel coffee from Wyndham. I don't have high expectations. I usually don't. Actually, not bad. Actually, kind of strong, which I like. Should wake me up here. Right on. But yeah, this is Moab, and I think we're heading into the downtown area where I had to go shopping for that piece of equipment I needed. And boy, was that a ripoff, just FYI. Don't forget, you know, your essentials when you go home, lest you pay three times the price. Let me show you what it is. It was this thing here, this doodad. Plugs into a cigarette lighter. I needed this AC input. What I really needed was this end and then a 8mm DC input, but I don't think anybody makes that anymore, or they don't sell it in this town. So this was kind of a hack, but I tried it and it worked, but it was a little bit of a fiasco. Place I got it from was going to be up on the left here. Parking sucked. It was hard to find parking, but it's called Arches Electronics. That was like the only game in town, and Amy had to call them and help figure that out. So thank you, Amy. You saved the trip. You see hotel after hotel here. We're not far from the entrance to Arches National Park on this side of town, so it's probably why all the hotels are over here. And they have Mavericks here. I like Maverick. It's probably my favorite gas station at the moment. It's like one of the few that I'll actually eat gas station food at. I had one of those tornado things, chicken Southwest tornadoes, on the road yesterday, and it was quite good and spicy. It was actually kind of hot. But anyway, that was Moab. You know, there was something back here. I always drive by it, Lions Park, and it's like a canyon here with a river. And I always wanted to just drive in here and see, like, what is this all about, like this Lions Park? There's like a bridge. I almost feel like I'm obligated to go stretch my legs before we get started, and I'm not really in a huge rush.
On Utah 128 toward Moab Canyon Pathway.
Okay, I know. See, she doesn't like
continue
it when you...
Continue on Utah 128 for 42 miles.
She does not like it when you,
turn right onto Utah 128,
get her
then turn right onto US 191 North.
Off the course there. Is there any price for this, or is it free? No smoking. Okay, no problem. No alcohol, no problem. Couldn't do it either if I wanted to. Not that I'd even want to. No price. So I think we're just gonna go walk over that bridge and take my coffee here. And I actually got double fisted here. I actually got two coffees here because they're so dang small. And I got my habit I gotta feed. So, all right, friends, let's go check this out and see what's up. There's bathrooms if you have to use the bathroom. All right, we'll leave Slim here for a moment as we walk out to that bridge or down. I don't know if you can walk along the riverbank or what this is. So every time I come to visit here, I'm like, oh, I want to come and check it out. And it's just usually I'm in the national parks and stuff and you don't have time. But yeah, look at that beautiful red rock of Utah here. The reason why so many come up here. And oh, look, there's like a sky ride over there too. I never noticed that before. What is that? I know there's a zip line thing somewhere over there. Maybe there's a zip line where that takes you to the top or something? How cool would that be? I would love to live in a place like this or retire for the landscapes, but I couldn't deal with the tourists and the hippies. Although, if you heard my music, you'd call me a hippie too. But I'm a different kind. Well, that's interesting. Looks like you could go to Arches from here. Maybe there's a different entrance, I guess? And is it for like bicyclists? Huh, this is a whole new region to explore some other time. Grand Staff Canyon, 3 miles up the road. I've not heard of Grand Staff Canyon. This might have some exploration potential in the future. These are the little moments. That's why this road trip video is fun. Because I can do whatever I want whenever it strikes my fancy, as long as it doesn't eat up too much of my time. Very large bridge. Ooh. And that's quite the river too. Out there, you see that? If I had my phone on me, I'd just look up to see what river it is, but I don't. But I'll look at my map when we get back in there. You can see it's flowing nice. You can see debris going down the river there at a nice clip. And there's a boat launch over there. Probably for river rafters, it's a pretty big boat launch. But it's a little cool, so you don't really see a lot of rafters just yet. But the season is upon us soon. All right, I downed my coffee. That did not take long. I'm gonna call these coffee shots. This is not a respectable sized coffee. Nobody ever gives you that at hotels. They always give you these dinky little cups. I need the king-sized cup, like the one that the Burger King would drink. He wouldn't drink this. Anyway, this is like a version of heaven, I would say, right outside of town. All right, so we are now departing here. And by the way, this river, the Colorado River, duh, I'm an idiot. I just looked at my Google map here. Like, that's the Colorado River, the same one that goes through the Grand Canyon. So we are north, of course, of the Grand Canyon. So, but you could see the Colorado flows marvelously up this ways. Hasn't been sucked dry like it does in my state. And look at that sight. You know, we're heading towards Canyonlands now, but look at those giant boulders up on yonder hillside there. That's magnificent. It's gonna let this roll for a minute. This is Utah. This is why Utah is my jam. And you know, just not that far back when we saw yesterday, I stopped at that Wilson Arch and you saw footage of me driving through Western Colorado. That landscape isn't far from here. And it just goes from that to this, boom, with very little transition. It just yanks your soul out your mouth for a second, and then you swallow it back in. And although I know a lot of this episode, this road trip is from the car, rightfully done, because we were sitting on our butts in the car driving for hour after hour after hour. It's just something you don't get to usually do, is hit the open highway and share it from the cockpit. So hopefully this is an enjoyable format. It's something Amy and I, you know, usually I'm on foot with a camera, not necessarily sitting on my butt here, but it's just such a convenient setup, and I got all these hours to do virtually nothing other than sit here and maybe listen to music. Anyway, that I would say was the Moab proper area. Now that we've climbed to the top of this plateau, I'm gonna cut it off for a minute or many until we get a little bit further on or I see something really interesting, which, you know me, probably that's 5 minutes up the road from here. All right, since I changed my mind, since we have a couple hours here of nothing to do, let me show you what Amy always complains about, my music, the road trip. I'm gonna play you my number one favorite album of the moment, Captain Beyond, their initial album, and you'll get a taste of what it's like to ride alongside of me here. You got a little taste of what Amy has to go through, although I don't play the music that loud with her in the car. So, yeah.
Continue for half a mile.
Captain Beyond. It's actually considered a super group of the early 1970s that had members of, I think, the original singer from Deep Purple, a well-known drummer named Bobby Caldwell, who played in various groups, and then two members of Iron Butterfly. And that first album, I think, is what many consider their best. It's kind of a, I don't know, some people consider it a cult classic. I never even heard of them, to be honest with you, until I really started getting into the music of that time. It's like I got Slim and Slim got me into this kind of music. It's not the only kind of music I listen to, but, you know, once you have your morning coffee and you got to get, you know, your spirit moving, that's how I do it. Let me continue with some of more of Amy's favorite hits that you'll hear on the road with me. I'm being sarcastic. She hates it. I know she hates it. Sometimes you gotta switch it up too. You can't always have that rock and roll. You gotta have a little bit of that twang too. On a road trip anyway. And this will do just fine.
Well, I bought a cherry liner, 40 tons of steel. I don't ever wanna see you crying.
But that's not all I'm about. I do like much more, and I'm gonna show you one more of my guilty pleasures. One of Amy's particular favorites, Iron Maiden. Sorry, Amy. All right, I think that's gonna do it. I'm losing my voice now and coughing and stuff, trying to sing some Iron Maiden. I can't sing in that register. But there you have it. You saw one side of me. There's many other sides musically that you have not yet seen, nor may you ever, but that's really the flavor of the moment. Like, I go through phases, and I think I've said before, I can't really claim to have a favorite band of all time. I just, sometimes, right now it's Captain Beyond, so 3 months from now, who the heck knows? All right, I've made it well into Colorado now, right in the Fruta, Colorado area. And here's Colorado National Monument, my next destination. And you know I'm a little bit of a tease, right? So I'm trying to tease you. I think we're gonna be driving straight up in there. Or maybe not, actually. I see the road going up that way. So I don't know where. There's like a scenic drive that goes through the whole monument, and I'm gonna be making a video on that, as well as one other thing I wanna do while I'm here. So you know what that means. If you wanna enjoy Colorado National Monument to its fullest with me, you're gonna have to tune into different episodes when I do that. But I am here. I finally made it. And I wanted to come here one other time before and got thwarted by bad weather. All right, so we're back. Little teaser, maybe a little bit more than a teaser here. I've been here in Colorado National Monument all day long. I did a drive all along the Rimrock Drive and stopped at almost every single overlook. Totally different video for that. I did some hiking, doing camping here, having a blast, and I'm heading back to the campground now, and it's getting close to sunset, and I don't think this is going to be the ideal area where you'd want to see a sunset here. I would guess on the eastern facing part of the park, facing west might be better, but I'm going to take you guys on a quick walk with me here, just to give you a little taste of what I did here during my time. All right, so what I'm gonna take you guys on here is another hike down Otto's Trail, quarter mile long, but this time, unlike my other video, it is late afternoon lighting and kind of a little bit of a ways from sunset still maybe. And I don't know if this is gonna be a good place for a sunset here anyway, but I just wanted to give you guys a glimpse, just a little taste. Now, if you see that protuberance on the other side, kind of right to the right of that is the campground, Saddlehorn Campground, where I'm camping this evening. Making a video about that too. So we've been very busy bees today. You know, as the Val Kilmer Doc Holliday like to say, you wanna say it first? Isn't that a dee diddly daisy? Ah, this is a good place to talk with you. You know, this is the day on my trip. It's like day three into this whole vacation where I think I've finally shaken off the work thoughts, you know? Those of you that work probably know what I mean. It's like I'm a busy guy when I'm busy, and I've always told you I love my job, and I do. But I've had just a really busy period and have been working crazy hours. Amy would agree and tell you that. And it's just, you think about work, you think about things you couldn't finish before you left, and, you know, but there's only so much human beings can do. I'm talking, I don't even want to say how many hours I worked one week. It's, you would think I'm sick. If I were a golden eagle, I would build a nest right on the top of that. Probably not. That'd be a horrible idea. Speaking of eagles, is that a vulture or a golden eagle? You see that? It's a large bird flying the currents of air. And here we are at my home base, Saddle Horn Campground. Just gonna give you a quick glimpse and pull into my camp spot. But really pretty views from up here facing that valley down below. And after this, I think the plan is I'm going to wash up. And when I say wash up, I mean I'm gonna go to the bathroom and splash water in my face. And that's washing up for now. And because I'm starving and I gotta eat. I am so hungry. I've had such a day of adventure and activity. For me anyway. Feels awesome. I feel really good right now. See that blue tent right there next to the campground host? That'll be me. So some of you have asked me for a little bit of a glimpse behind the scenes or more into my home or the home I try to make when I'm away from home. There's moths flying around, so I really need to close my tent up here very quickly. They're coming. These are really cramped quarters. It would be easier if I had the door open, but I don't want the moths to come in. So, and this is my bed. So I have a cot. It folds. That's three sections basically. It's from REI. I think it's the King to Cot 3. It's a little pricey. It's really bulky to transport around, but I'm off the ground by a good ways and I could stow stuff underneath it. And it's way more comfortable than the ground, like by far. I usually sleep like a baby, to be honest, in this thing. So basically, you could see here inside the other end where my feet are sticking out. That's my equipment. So I've got toiletries, got clothing, and then where I like to keep my wallet and keys and stuff so I don't lose them. And yeah, other than keeping an eye on batteries and stuff so I could swap them out, that's pretty much my night. I can either read a book or play the Nintendo Switch. I think I'm gonna do some Switch.